tuning in. Today I am going to be working with this mold that I have. This makes a little, like a little, I don't know, ring bowl, trinket bowl. I just got these. They came in a set of four, and this is the biggest one. And I like the pattern on it. It's kind of hard to see. Let me see if I can turn it inside out. It kind of reminds me of peacock feathers. So I picked out some peacock colors. These are just resin pigments in blue diamond and emerald green. These are both shimmers. Then I have some copper pearl X mica powder in super copper. So my plan is to use the mica, paint around the edge, and then I want to hit these little round dots with the copper. And then I'm gonna pour the color in. So my hope is that this turns out looking like peacock feathers, but we shall see. I poured some water in this to measure how much resin this would take, and it's 5 ounces for this little bowl. So that surprised me. I thought it would be less, but looks like 5 ounces. So the first thing I'm gonna do is paint with the mica. And to do that, I do have to turn this inside out. Or at least make it more accessible. Let's see. Sorry if I'm going out of frame. It's hard to do this. All right, I think. It's funny because I had it turned inside out before I set it down. And I thought, oh, I should probably show them what it looks like before I turn it inside out. Now I can't get it to go. Oh, there we go. Anyways, the reason I'm turning it inside out is because I need to get the paintbrush into the mold, and if it's not turned inside out, or it's not really inside out, but if this is in the way, I can't get the paintbrush in there. So that's what I'm doing. I'm just pulling that out of the way. So I'm gonna open this up. And for dry painting with mica, what I found, you need a brush that has natural bristles. If you're using a brush with polyester bristles, they're very staticky, and then your mica is gonna go everywhere. It's not gonna go where you want on the mold. So it really helps if you have natural bristles. It's usually like boar's hair. I forget what other types of bristles they are, but that seems to help with the static. So I just get a little on the brush, I tap it off, because otherwise it will kind of go everywhere. And then you just kind of paint it, and it's just dry painting. And getting it exactly where you want it isn't the easiest in something like this. If you're doing a coaster where it's a flat surface, it is a little bit easier, but even still, this is, even with the coasters, it's not an exact science because mica is a powder. So yeah, I'm just gonna go and do this. I'm not gonna make you watch me do the whole thing because that will take forever. But it's basically the same technique through the whole thing. So I will do this and then I will come back. Okay, it's all done. Let me see if I can show you. So there is, as you can tell, it's not perfectly neat and clean in there. For this particular pour, I actually don't care. I kind of want a little bit of a mess. If you don't want it, if you want it much more exact and you want to remove any of that kind of overflow that happened or scatter, what I do is I take a Q-tip and I dip it in some rubbing alcohol and I just kind of wipe where I don't want the mica to be. And that usually cleans it up pretty good. But I'm okay with it being a little messy. All right, so I have my resin mixed up. I have about 5.5 ounces or so there. And I'm just going to make up my colors. I'm just going to get 2 cups. I'm just gonna do half and half. Hopefully this will fit in these cups. These are 3-ounce cups. Make sure I'm in frame here. I always work too close to myself and then you can't see what I'm doing. All right. All right, so there's still a little bit left in the cup, but I don't want to put too much in these because I'm not going to be able to mix them. All right, so I'm just going to grab a couple of popsicle sticks here. All right, so these pigment pastes, you do have to stir them up before you use them. A lot of times the pigment that's inside of these will settle. It's a powdered pigment, so it'll settle down to the bottom. If you don't stir it, then you don't get nice, even color. All right, and then I'm just gonna scoop out about that much. We'll start with that. I want these colors to be really rich and opaque, so if I need to add a little more, I will. It's just a little too translucent. It's almost solid. It's almost opaque, but it's not quite. So I'm going to add a little more color. Swipe my stick off. You don't want to dip your stick with resin on it into your container. Okay, that is beautiful. All right, and now for the blue diamond. This is one of my favorite pastes from Just Resin. I am on my third container already. This one's a little thicker. You'll find that the consistency of these is all unique too. Some are really, really thick and some are a lot thinner. I'm gonna take a bigger scoop so I don't have to come back in a second time. All right, perfect. All right, so I wanna kind of marble these, and I would order, normally I would just pour them back into this cup and do the marbling, but since there's clear in there, I don't want to get the clear mixed in. So I'm gonna get a clean cup. I try to reuse my cups as much as I can, but all right, so what I'm gonna do is pour these both in here. All right, and then I'm gonna mix them, but just a tiny bit. All I want to do is kind of swirl the colors together. I don't want to combine the colors. So that's all I'm going to do is just that little bit. I don't know if you can see. Yeah, so you can see the colors are kind of swirled together. And then as I pour, I'm going to just kind of swirl the cup around a little bit and just encourage those colors to just move around a little more organically than just a straight pour. And as you can see, it is not quite filled up all the way, and that's because there's still some left in this cup. So what I'm going to do is add just a little bit of color to what's left in here and just add that in there because I want it filled to the top. Let me just grab a little bit of this blue. Probably don't even need that much, but hard because this is such a tiny amount in this cup. This is, it's less than an ounce, but All right, so we're gonna let this cure, and I can't wait to unmold it. I'm so excited to see what this looks like. All right, so we'll see you tomorrow. We'll get this out of here. All right, all cured. I'm super excited to get this out of here. It looks really good. We'll see what the mica did. I'm hoping for that peacock feather look. These are always fun to demold. Probably need to get some water. All right, I'm gonna go get some water. I'll be right back. Okay, so if you can't get these deeper pores out of a mold, this is kind of a trick you can use. Get a little water in there, a little bit of soap. You can see that peeling away now. Oh, that looks pretty. That is so cool. All right, so definitely got too much of the copper in there, but I don't hate it. I think it looks really neat. I'll just have to be a little neater with my mica application next time. The inside looks nice. That turned out really cool. There's no bubbles that I see. It's kind of hard to tell with all the soap suds now. But it looks really good. Wow. That turned out awesome. So as usual, thank you so much for tuning in. And if you enjoyed the video, please subscribe and share it with your friends. And I will see you next time.